everyone. Today's session is for strength and balance. So before we start doing any exercise, we need to be sitting towards the front of our chair. So let me just show you from the side. So what we'll need to do is to walk our bottom forward on the chair. So you walk towards the front. And you should have a gap there at the back. I'm going to sit up nice and tall, shoulders relaxed and down, and we're looking forwards. And we're going to start off by just lifting up our heels. So just one foot at a time. So working all those muscles in the feet and ankles. So just lifting up those heels. Remember to keep up nice and tall, looking forward, shoulders relaxed. Just a couple more. And let's hold it there. This time we're going to bring our toes off the floor. So bringing the weight onto our heels. So it's nice and steady. Nice and controlled. Let's go back to those heel raises again. Change it into a pedal. So as one foot comes up, the other foot goes down. Okay, and let's take that into a little march. So you can let your hands, arms and loose at the side. Remember, it's shoulders back and down. So we're just marching on the spot. So we're looking forwards. We're breathing normally. You can breathe in through the nose and in through through the mouth. Now let's start to make this move a little bit faster now. Remember to keep up tall, no slouching, nice and tall, shoulders relaxed, lifting those feet off the floor. And trying to land with your heels, lifting up through the toes. And take a bit of practice from that. Okay, we're going to bring that to a stop. To let our arms and down loose by the side, we're going to do a shoulder roll. So I'm going to show you from the side. So when your arms are loose, we bring the shoulders forwards, we take the shoulders up towards our ears, we take them back, and we take them down. Yeah. So we're going to do four of these. So nice and tall, shoulders back and down, feet about width apart. Let's bring the shoulders forward. Take them up towards our ears, take them back, and take them down. It's really good if you ever feel a bit of stress in your neck and shoulders, a bit tight, a bit of tightness. This exercise is really good. Good for releasing tension. So nice big circles. Got one more. Okay, let's go back into that marching. You can just let your arms swing at the side, sitting up tall. Nice and relaxed. Okay, let's bring that to a stop. So this time we're going to mobilize the ankles. Can hold onto your chair if you need to. So we're just going to take the foot slightly forward, placing the heel down on the floor, sitting up tall. Let's lift up, and we're going to place our toes on the same spot, so just tapping down. Let's lift up, heel down. Lift up, toe down. Two more, so lift up, heel down. Lift up, toe down. And lift up, heel down. And lift up, toe down, and place your foot back on the floor. Let's just have a little march. Bring the arms in a little bit more now. Trying not to slam the feet down. Pulling your abdominals, muscles in, so belly button into spine. And let's bring that to a stop. Let's take your other foot forward slightly, so we're going to place that heel on the floor. Remember, we're nice and tall, shoulders back. We're going to lift up, point the toe down, toe goes on the same spot. So let's lift up, heel down. Lift back into those marches. I'm starting to bring the arms in a bit more now. So we've got a bit of an angle on the elbows. Keeping up tall. So our next exercise is going to be for the waist. So we're just stretching out around the middle. Good for your spine. So let's bring that to a stop. So we're going to, again, sit up nice and tall. We're going to place one hand on the opposite knee. Other hand goes round to the back of the chair. We're going to lift up, and then we're going to turn, so your shoulders and head is going round. So we'll look into the side. Just go around as far as you can go. Let's bring it back to the centre, and let's swap our hands over. So hand on your opposite knee, other hand round to the back. Lift up first, and then we're turning. The shoulders go around. Let's bring that back to centre. Swap your hands over. So cross in, lift up and turn. Bring it back to centre and cross over. Lift and then turn. So that's two. We're going to do two more. So cross and to the back, lift and turn. It's really good for if you're driving. Checking your blind spot. So it's lift and turn. And last time, lift up and turn. Back to centre and crossing over. Okay then, so let's go back to those little marches. So we're going to do a little bit of strength work on our legs. So let's hold it there. So I'm going to show you from the side. So I'm going to sit up nice and tall. And very slowly we're going to slide one foot across the floor. And we're just going to lift up the foot so we've got a straight leg. And we can pull the toes in as well. So you're going to feel that tension in the thigh muscle. So really good for strengthening your legs. And we're going to take it back down. Then we're going to do the other leg. So slide the foot forward. Let's lift up. Pull the toes in. We'll hold for a few seconds, up to 5 seconds. Try not to slouch. And take your foot back down. Okay, we'll do three more of those. Slide the foot forward, lift the foot off the floor, pull the toes in. 2, 3, 4, 5, and slowly back down. Now if you count under your breath, the 5, it means you're not going to be able to hold your breath. So it's really useful. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and foot back down. Try and keep up tall. Stretch yourself if you're starting to slouch. Take your foot forward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And foot back down. So really good for strengthening your legs. Really good for knees if you've got a bit of joint pain. It's really good for strengthening the muscles that support your knees. So we'll do one more either side. So lifting up. End. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and back down. Round again, slowly lifting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, well done everybody. So the next one is another one that's going to work your leg muscles. Again, I'm going to show you from the side. So when we're sat in our chair, might find you sat at the back. So again, we need to come forward. So it's that hip walk forward. So you're shifting your weight from one bum cheek to the other one to bring yourself forward. We're going to bring the feet back. So the heels are still down on the floor. We lean forward and it's a big push. You're pushing through your legs. 3, 2, 1, push up. When you've got to the top, just pedal your feet a little bit. Now, if you want to walk back so you know the chair is there, we're going to start to lower the hips, bending the knees. We're looking forwards. We're going to reach for the chair. That chair's still there, so I know I can safely land at the back. Okay. So, do that again. Hip walk forward. Bring the feet back. Lean forward. 3, 2, 1. We're going to push up. Pedal of the feet. Let's walk back. Feel for the chair. Bend your knees. Lower your hips. Reach for the chair. And back down. So we'll do it 2 more times. Hip walk forward. It's really good for strengthening these thigh muscles. Really helps when we're walking upstairs, walking up hills. Bring the weight forward. 3, 2, 1. Push up. Pedal the feet, walk back, feel for the chair, back of your legs. This time we're going to do it a bit slower, so really slow, lowering yourself back down. Really strengthen these thigh muscles, so as slow as you can. Try not to drop straight down. And last time then, walking the hips forward, bringing the feet back, leaning forward, 3, 2, 1. Up to standing, a little bit of a pedal on the feet, and let's walk it back. Feel for the chair, back of the legs start to lower down nice and slow. We're lowering the hips, we're bending the knees. Feel for the chair if you want, so make sure you're going to land on that chair. Slowly, slowly. Try and avoid your knees coming together, keep that gap between your knees. Okay, so if you want to come up to standing, or we can do seated. So I'll show the exercise seated first. What we're going to do is, it's for balance, is this one. This is to raise our heels. So if we're doing it seated, feet about width apart, again, up nice and tall, shoulders back and down. Just going to take our weight onto our toes and lift our heels off the floor. We're going to come up for 3 and down for 5. Nice and simple. If we're standing, recommend you stand at the back of the chair. So you've got the chair for support. Feet about in width apart. Looking forward, shoulders are back and relaxed. And you can use as much support as you want. It might be both hands. It might be just fingertips on both hands. It might be one hand, fingertips on one. Just one fingertip on both hands. It might be no hands, so you just have your hands just in front of the chair. So you choose which you want to do. So nice and tall, shoulders back and down. We're taking the weight forward. We're going to lift up, keeping the weight over your big toe and second toe. Up for 3, and we're going to come down for 5. So we're slowing it down on the downward movement. We're trying to go straight up, so we're not leaning forward, we're not leaning back. So again, take the weight forward into your toes, start to lift your heels. 1, 2, 3, coming up. Keep that weight of your big toe and second toe so the ankles are straight. Bring back down for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So we're going to do this 2 more times. Take your weight forward to your toes, start to lift up. 1, keep those ankles straight. And we're down for 5. 5. About that support, can you do it with a little bit less support? So taking it forward, weight into your toes, lifting the heels, and back down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, our next exercise is exactly the same, but we're going to take our weight onto our heels. So seated, feet hip width apart. To lift up the toes, just take the weight into our heels. So again, we're coming up slowly. You can hold at the top there for a few seconds and then back down. Standing, exactly the same. So nice and tall, shoulders back and down. Feet about hip width apart. I'm going to just lift up the toes don't try and lift too far and stick your bottom out. So we need to keep up nice and straight. So let's have another go. Looking forward, shoulders relaxed. Use the chair for support if you need it. Lift up the toes, weight onto your heels. Just hold a few seconds and take it back down. This is going to challenge your balance. Let's do that again. Let's support if you can. So lift up the toes, take the weight onto your heels. Keep it up nice and tall, holding a few seconds, and then back down. So let's do that again. Lift up the toes, weight onto the heels. Take your weight back, hold. Take the feet back down. And again, so lift up the toes, take the weight onto the heels, just hold. Hold a bit longer this time, and take it back down. Okay, then, so our next exercise, we're going to do standing. We're going to stand on one leg. So again, I'll show you from the side, nice and tall, shoulders back and down. If you're using a chair for support, or you can use a wall, I'm just going to take the weight of the leg that's nearest that support. I'm going to slide the other leg back, and we're going to lift our heel off the floor. So we're standing a bit like a flamingo, and we're going to hold for 5 seconds. Then we bring the foot back down, and we step out to the side. Now, if you can't do standing, you need to do seated. You can go back to just sliding foot on the floor and just lifting up. And we'll work a bit more on strengthening the thigh muscles. Okay, we'll do that again. So weight nearest the chair, take your foot back. Lifting up your foot, so you're standing on one leg. Think about that support. Do you need all that support? Can you do a little bit less? Maybe no hands. So holding up for about 10 seconds, sorry. And foot back down, just step out to the side. And again, so bring the foot back in. Stand nice and tall. Take the weight of the leg nearest the chair. Take the heel up. Hold it there, keep breathing. Reduce that support if you can. If your leg's wobbling, that's fine. That means you're trying to control your balance. Foot down and step out. And let's do another one. So weight on the leg nearest the chair. Bring your foot in. Then slide the foot back, lifting the toes off the floor, looking forwards, relax the shoulders, keep breathing. Slowly foot back down and step out to the side. Okay, we need to do the same on the other side. Turn around. Again, it's the weight on the chair, on the leg nearest the chair, nice and tall, belly button pulled into spine. Take the weight on the leg nearest the chair, slide the other foot back. Just lift that foot off the floor. One, two. Foot back down, step out to the side, get your balance back. So bring your foot back in, let's do that again. Take the weight of the leg nearest the chair, slide the other foot back. One, two. Foot down, step out. And let's do that one again. Nice and tall, weight on the leg nearest the chair, slide your other foot back. Foot down, step out. So we'll do one more of these. Try and reduce that support if you can. So bring foot in, nice and tall. Take the weight of the leg nearest the chair, slide the foot back, hold it for 10 seconds. Foot down and step out. Okay then. So our next exercise, we're going to do a little bit of stretching now. So we've worked the legs. Important that we stretch them out. Okay, so nice and tall, shoulders back and down again. So we're just going to take one leg forward and we're going to turn up the toes. Place our hands above our bent knee on the other leg. We're going to lift up. Deep breath in, lift up, and we're going to go forward from our hips. So we're keeping a straight back. So if you're sat towards the front of your chair, you will get a straight leg and you'll start to feel this stretch down the back of the straight leg. I'm just going to hold it there, up to 20 seconds. You need to breathe normally. And bring yourself back up, bring your foot back in. Let's do the same on the other leg. So nice and tall. Slide your foot forward. Have your toes lifted, but you can relax your foot. Place your hand above your bent knee on your other leg. Let's lift up first. Then we're going to go forwards. I'm going to hold for 20 seconds. So let me just show you that from the side. So we've got a nice straight back, we're not arching. And the stretch. You should be able to feel it down the back of the leg. As you can see, I've got a gap there at the back of my chair. So we're holding up to 20 seconds. We need to remember to keep breathing throughout. And bring yourselves back up and foot back in. Okay, this next exercise is for stretching the chest. So really good for posture. We're going to take both arms round to the back. Again, sit up nice and tall, and we're going to take the shoulders back. So you can hold onto the chair if you wish, or you can place your hands in your lower back, trying to get your elbows closer together. So it's just normal breathing. So really good for posture, it makes us take our shoulders back. Good for breathing, because if our shoulders are back, actually expand our lungs a bit more, less restriction. So normal breathing, breathing through your nose and breathing out through your mouth. Stretching the front of the shoulders as well. Again, rolled in at least for 20 seconds. Next one for the calf muscles, and again you can just take the foot just slightly forward and we're going to lift up the toes. So think about pulling your toes up towards your shin. Again, we're sitting up tall, so no slouching, relaxing the shoulders and just really pulling up. Now if you ever get cramp in your calf muscle, this is a really good stretch to do to try and release that cramp, ease the cramp off. So just pulling those toes up, you can also push the heel down, so that might increase the stretch. Again, rolled in for about 20 seconds, breathing normally. Breathing in through the nose, down through the mouth. That stretch. Bring your foot back in, take your other foot out slightly, and let's lift up the toes. So pulling those toes up towards the shin, so you should feel a stretch in the calf muscle. And sit up tall. I'm going to push the heel down. So getting a big stretch in the calf. normally into the mouth and out through the nose. Pulling that foot up, keep pushing that heel down. And last time. Okay, let's slowly release that stretch. So we're going to sit up nice and tall in our chair. Let your arms hang loose by the side. And let's just roll the shoulders round. So bring the shoulders forward, up, back, and down. And again, bring the shoulders forward, up, back, and down. So try to make this circle as big as you can. Let's take our arms through the waist. So we're going to bring it forward. Sorry, we're going to take it back, up, forward, and down. Imagine you're drawing a circle with your shoulders. It's really good for tension in the neck and shoulders. Last time. Okay, this time I'm going to bring the shoulders up towards our ears and take them back down. Imagine you've got heavy shopping bags in your hands. Bring the shoulders up. Take them back down. Again, a few more times, and again, this is really good if you ever tense in your neck and shoulders. This is a really good exercise to do this one and the shoulder circles. This time. Okay, and we're going to finish off by just taking our arms up, round, all the way back down into a circle. Deep breath in and breathe it out. And last time, deep breath in and breathe it out. And give yourselves a clap. Well done, everybody. Hope you've enjoyed today's session.